In the last video, we will talk up to due process of law. Today, we will start the roles of Indian judiciary. So, Indian judiciary comprises of the high courts, subordinate courts, and other tribunals. The roles of these courts, along with their composition, powers, and procedures for functioning, have been elaborated in the Constitution. So if we look different roles of the Supreme Court in India, that it is one of the most powerful courts anywhere in the world. However, its functions is within the limitations imposed by the Constitution, as no one is above the Constitution. The Supreme Court has specific jurisdiction, which we can say simply the scope of powers. If we look at the first jurisdiction of the Supreme Court, that is original jurisdiction, which is entertained under Article 131 provided in the Constitution. So if we look at the cases that can be directly considered by the Supreme Court without going to the lower court before that, are comes under original jurisdiction. The original jurisdiction of the Supreme Court established it an empire, means the father of all, in all dispute regarding federal matters. So here the term comes, what is federal matters? The legal disputes that are bounded to arise between the union and the state and among the states themselves, means any matter which is between two states or our union and our one of any state, then they are considered as federal matters. In this type of case, the state or the nation can visit Supreme Court without going to the any other high courts in India. Original jurisdiction has the power to resolve such cases. It is also called as original jurisdiction because the Supreme Court alone has the power to deal with such cases. No any other court in India, even high court of any state, can't deal with this type of cases. In this capacity, the Supreme Court not just settles disputes but also interprets the power of union and the state government had laid down in the Constitution. If we look one other jurisdiction of the Supreme Court, that is writ jurisdiction, which is entertained under Article 32, which is also called as heart and soul of the Constitution by one of the prominent member, who is Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. And again, same writ jurisdiction is also for high courts, in which under Article 226 High Court also issue writs. So what is writ jurisdiction? Any individual whose fundamental rights has been violated can be directly moved to Supreme Court for remedy under the Article 32, that is a constitutional remedy. High Court can also issue writ, but it is the choice of person to select if he want to go to High Court or Supreme Court. Now one other type of jurisdiction, which is our third, that is appellate jurisdiction, which is entertained under Article 136 of the Indian Constitution. Supreme Court, that is the highest court of appeal, so a person can appeal to the Supreme Court against the decision of High Court. However, a clause here that High Court must clarify that the case is good for appeal. Generally, they give the permission. Then in this case, if any appellate jurisdiction case in the court, then the Supreme Court will reconsider the case and the legal issues involved in it. Here the term reconsidering means viewing all the legal matters that are related to the case. The Supreme Court thinks that the law of Constitution has a different meaning from what lower court understood, then the Supreme Court will change the ruling, along with that also give new interpretation to the provision involved, and that is binding over all high court in the country. One other jurisdiction is that is advisory jurisdiction, which is entertained under Article 143 of the Indian Constitution. This means that President of India can refer any matter that is related to public importance on that which involves interpretation of the Constitution to the Supreme Court for advice. Here also one clause is added that the Supreme Court is not bound to give advice on such matters, and the President is also not bound to accept such an advice. Basically, it is given only for that the government to seek legal option on a matter of improving better taking action on it. This may prevent unnecessary litigations, and the light of the advice of the Supreme Court, the government makes suitable changes in its actions or legislations. One more type of of jurisdiction that is entertained under the Supreme Court, that is public interest litigation, PIL. Or in Hindi we can say Janhit Yachika. So the public interest litigation fielded in a court of law for the protection of public interest, such as you can say pollution, terrorism, or road safety and constitutional hazards, etc. Any matter where the interest of public at large is affected can be readdressed by filing a public litigation in a court of law. And one thing that to be noted, that public interest litigation is not defined in any statute or in any act. It has been interpreted by judges to consider the intent of a public at large. This public interest litigation came in after the Husainera Khatun versus Bihar case, that is in 1979. One more term come from this case, that is judicial activism. It becomes more proactive by the case. If we look at the some roles of PLI are, individuals as part of society must have right to seek justice wherever such rights were violated. Judiciary started considering rights of those sections who cannot easily approach the courts, means they are poor or weak from society. PLI is the power given to the public by the courts through judicial activism. That come in more proactive by Husainera Khatun versus Bihar case in 1979. That is given by a justice whose name is Justice P.N. Bhagavati. However, the person who is filling the petition must prove to the satisfaction of the court that the petition is being filled for a public interest and not for just frivolous litigation. One more thing, that the court can itself take cognizance of the matters and proceed suo motu, or cases can commence on the petition of any public spirited individuals. If we look at the some matters that are entertained under PIL are bonded labor matters, non-payment of minimum wages to workers and exploitation of casual workers, or atrocities on women, food adulteration, environmental pollution and disturbance of ecological balance, etc. This suo motu is borrowed from American jurisprudence that provides legal representation of groups like poor. If we look some limitations of PILR, there are many litigations fielded in the frivolous PIL with vested interest. Cases may be delayed or delayed in disposal of PIL cases. And also one more important thing, that is cases of judicial overreach, which is not good for government. If we look towards High Court, then it is organ of jurisdiction administration at state level. They have powers to issue directives, orders or writ within their jurisdiction. Its role is almost similar to Supreme Court in the existence of public interest litigation. So today that's all. In the next part, we will cover independence and impartiality of Indian judiciary, which is under Article 50.